Maybe Gator, maybe.
Gator doesn't want it.
That's, they don't want the choice.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they get to, they get to, they submit who they want. They submit who they want.
Alrighty, good win. Happy for our seniors. You know, come out and play well. You know, really, really proud of our players and handling the week and, you know, going through all the stuff. So we're really excited for them moving forward. You know, as far as injuries concerned, Treon's fine. He had a contusion on the lower part of his knee. There's no ligament. There's no cartilage. There's no issues. He just had it started swelling up a little bit on him. It was a good hit he took. And it started to tighten up a little bit, so that's why we pulled him. So he ought to be fine as far as I don't think we had any other injuries as far as any of that. But proud of the players. I'll open up for any questions.
Pat?
Yeah, Will, can you just talk about these guys? And obviously Eastern Kentucky was throwing everything they had at you,
yeah.
All kinds of trick plays and everything. And to be able to stay focused with all that was going on around them.
Well, Pat, this is what they do. I mean, they're a multiple formation punt team. They motion, they shift every down. It's a new bag of tricks every single game. So we just told our guys to be ready for whatever comes up. There's going to be some things we're not prepared for that you're going to have to adjust on the fly and understand that. The onside kick we had prepared for, you know, you can't make contact unless the ball's going 10 yards. In that situation, that was the call there. So I knew right when that happened, that's what they had called. But the fake field goal, we had hadn't practiced that look, but we had practiced a look like it. So again, all those situations you got to be prepared for, and pleased with how we responded to those deals.
Well, how emotional was the day for you, especially at the end there, coming off the field for the last time?
Again, it'll hit me when the season's over. I've already switched gears to next week. I mean, that's just what we do.
Mark,
much needed win though for the program and for the seniors and for yourself, everything.
Yeah, no doubt.
Okay, and then how good was it?
Are you giving an opinion or what?
I was asking. It was a question.
What do you think, Mark?
Sometimes you have to ask questions. You know
the
answer.
It's like the conference call on Wednesday. Hey, Coach, how you doing? Boy, I'm great. Yeah. Got canned Sunday. That's really good. What do you got?
All right, and then seeing Jeff get back on the field. I mean, a guy who's had some confidence issues.
Yeah, I mean, Jeff's certainly capable. And we've struggled a little bit with Treon throwing the ball. You know, I mean, we just have. But he threw a really nice corner route to DeMarcus. Treon did beautiful throw. DeMarcus made a fantastic play on the ball. Good deep ball there to Quentin. But Jeff's certainly capable of playing extremely well. I've got a lot of confidence in him. And unfortunately, we went through a stretch there. We didn't take care of the ball at the position, and we didn't move the football consistently enough. And we've had some success going another direction. But I have all the confidence of Jeff. Given the opportunity, we'll perform well.
Treon is still the starter for FSC, though, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, you know, Jeff, a lot coming in, you know, people say, hey, he graduated, he has a chance to transfer, choice, whatever. Do you kind of think about that going into today, knowing that it is senior day, and he would have been a senior if it wasn't for that injury?
Sure. I mean, I haven't gone in the fine-tooth detail of things like that, but I mean, certainly, having him graduated, and he's in graduate school. I think being in graduate school is important to him. He was drafted by the Red Sox a year ago, so they've got their rights to him. So, you know, that's a decision that he and his family will sit down and make at some point.
Have you talked to him about it?
No, I have not. And again, that's something that I always tell the players in those situations. I'm here for you. If you need some advice and you want to talk about it, I'm more than welcome to give you my input.
Edgar, and then Pat.
Oh, yeah. Well, just could you just kind of discuss the day a few of the seniors had? Mike Taylor, Quentin, Mike McNeely getting that touchdown at the end.
Yeah, that was big. You know, Mike's been a guy that's done a fantastic job for us on special teams. I think everybody's, you know, points to the fake against Georgia, but he's really done. He's been a really good cover guy for us on punt, on kickoff. I mean, kickoff return, he does a great job. You know, Mike Taylor, hating Ron Ball didn't get to play today. You know, he's had a fantastic year, and what a story he is. Break your heart hearing what he has been through and what a wonderful young man he is. Max Garcia had a fantastic senior year. Trent Brown's coming off the injury, thought he played well. Chaz Green's had a really good senior year. Quentin had a couple touchdowns there, so that was good for him. Get him back in the fold, you know. Jabari Gorman's played solid football for us this year. So proud of him. Darius Cummings, he didn't jump off sides today, so that's good. But, yeah, he did, actually. I thought it was Caleb.
He didn't get
called,
it's 50-50 on either one of them, you know. Caleb didn't get called on it. But, no, Darius has really played well this year. He plays square on blocks. He plays with his hands extremely well. He leverages blocks very well. You know, he has really had a good year. He's really helped himself for the next level based on a lot of the information that I'm getting on how he has played, how he's handled himself. But he's played extremely well. And, of course, Mike Taylor. I'm trying to think through anybody else. But those guys, you know, again, you know, Kyle punted the ball well. You know, we hit some nice punts there, so happy for that. Yeah.
Pat, right?
Will, can you just talk about during the week, obviously this coaching staff and the players stayed focused. Was there – it had to be a concern, but, I mean, could you just see all through the week as it went along?
You know, Monday we didn't get out. We had some weather, and we – you know, we watched film and had some walkthroughs. Tuesday's practice was just okay. You know, that was not a great deal, not a great effort going out there. I wouldn't say it was a lack of effort, probably a lack of focus, energy, probably the word you ought to look for. You know, honestly, Wednesday was a little better, but okay. And then we have a team meeting every Thursday kind of to discuss the week and the weekend, what we're facing. And I sat the team down. I went through a situation when I played in college. I lost my coordinator and position coach after my junior year. I'd walked on. I'd earned a scholarship. I'd earned a starting job. I was mad at the head coach. I was mad at everybody. I'd earned my spot. I'd earned my position, and I felt like here I go again. I've got to earn my spot all over again. And the new position coach came in. There's a guy named Steve Dennis. I couldn't stand him the first 2 weeks. And then you know what? Now I still talk to the guy about once a month, and he's a very close, loyal friend of mine. So, you know, sometimes change is good, and they need to be very open to the change. I discussed my transition coming here, and it was hard. Because it was a divided locker room that had guys that didn't want to buy into anything but what they wanted and how it affected them. And I told them, you know, they're going to hire a really good football coach. Jeremy's going to hire a good coach. So why don't you give the guy a chance and buy into what the guy's trying to do instead of going through a total rocky road the first year where it's miserable for everybody involved. And, you know, hopefully they'll do that. But they heard it from me, and I told them that that's what they needed to do. They needed to make good decisions moving forward. If they're in a situation as a junior, they don't need to just say, I don't want to play for a new staff. That's ridiculous. You're making a business decision, not a personal decision when you do that. But, you know, buy into what the guy's trying to tell you, you know, and give the guy an opportunity and buy into what he's trying to do. You know, and that's what they need to do. Thursday, for whatever reason, I had a couple of the questions asked, and then we went out there, and I thought we had a very sharp Thursday. We knew we outmanned them. If we just stayed focused, we played with effort, and we executed and took care of the football, we'd win the game.
So you feel like they, once they kind of heard that from you, they won?
I think so. I think that, you know, you those guys, but you know what? These guys are all resilient, you know. It's frustrating after a tough defeat. You get on the bus. And, you know, you're 2 hours after a game and some of them are joking. But they take it much different than we do. They look forward to the next opportunity. You know, when they hire the new guy, they'll all come in here and talk about how wonderful he is and how great it is. That happens everywhere. You know, what else are they going to say? We really don't like the guy? No, they're going to say how much they love the guy. So that's just part of it, you know. And that's just, that's how these things go.
They did that with you when you came.
I know it. I remember. Yeah. You know? They do everywhere.
Coach, I know Neron had surgery Monday. Was there any way that he could have gone out, crutched out, done something today for senior day?
No. He had a microfracture issue with the leg, and he is on no mobility for 6 weeks, and he's down for at least 4 months. So he'll be fine.
I didn't mean play. I just meant come out.
Oh,
for
I thought you meant play.
No. Just come out for senior day, sir.
We can shoot him up, I guess, but. He
just for senior day ceremony.
But they didn't wheel him out to the 50-yard line?
They did. He was up.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought he was.
You can transcribe.
200-yard receivers today. I think that's the first time that's happened during your tenure. What
yeah,
it mean to get the kind of
years for that to happen?
Yeah, production from that position and DeMarcus Robinson's.
Well, I mean, again, when people are going to play you single high, you got to be able to take some shots down the field. We missed several last week, killed us in the game, you know, and then. You just got to hit those opportunities, and we were accurate with the deep ball, and I think we only missed one in the game, if I remember right. So I was pleased with that, yeah. That's good.
Coach, can you just talk about your defense coming out and setting the tone early? They've had a couple slow starts this year, but they set the tone this game.
But, yeah, I thought if, you know, we'd be able to dominate on the line of scrimmage. The back's a good player. Mobley's a really very good player. I was worried about him getting rolling a little bit. We didn't tackle as well, and we didn't finish on some tackles as well as I thought we should. But, you know, the zone read hurt us a little bit in the second quarter there. We didn't handle the quarterback very well. But other than that, yeah, played well. We should.
And going off of that, during the second half, you had you played a lot of your younger guys, a lot of freshmen, a lot of sophomores. Just about, what was your evaluation of them towards the end of the game?
Well, I think, again, I think we got some very good players in the program, and I think you look at a Caleb Brantley continues to mature, a Joey Ivey. You know, I hate that we had to, because of some injuries last year, had to burn his red shirt. I really would. He should be a red shirt freshman right now. You know, but both of those guys continue to come along as young players. Alex Angelone's made some plays for us. He's going to be a good player. Hey, you know, Jared Davis got hurt, but he's had a fantastic year. Alex McAllister continues to, you know, build on his explosive power and get adding a little weight. He's going to be a really good football player. He can flip his hips in the rush. He's a guy that needs to come on, you know, needs to keep just getting more. Every snap he gets, he's going to get better. You know, in the secondary, they're all back. So, you know, so they, you know, Quincy and Jalen, I wish he had, you know, he got that ball out in the end zone, but he should have intercepted that one ball. You know, he I've seen him make that play a lot. So, and then the young safeties are going to be very good. You know, Keanu still had a little bit of a tweak of the ankle, but I think he's going to be fine. We held him in the second half. He probably could have played, but we held him.
And Marcel Harris, he played a lot on special teams this year. Yeah. What was your thought of him playing on the defense,
though? Well, you know, he just needs to continue to come on, you know, assignment-wise with some things. But, again, Marcel really is a true freshman. Because last year with the knee, he really missed all football. He didn't really do much until about mid-season, and he was so far behind, it was hard to catch back up. So technically to me, this is like his true freshman season. And that's what he and everybody around him and all of us need to understand. He's like a true freshman right now, and it's just hard sometimes, especially at safety, as much as we do with those guys and the communication things we do. Those guys, I mean, it's hard, you know, to play as a true freshman. It is. You know?
Jesse,
Will, just with the difficulties this week and how trying everything was, how gratifying was it for you and probably the rest of the staff that everyone out there just looked like they were having fun?
Yeah, well, I mean, again, I think that, you know, the fun's in winning. We had a bunch of fun in Jacksonville, you know. So fun's in winning games. That's the bottom line.
Quentin Dunbar has 2 touchdowns today. Kind of what is your lasting memory of him as his?
This guy that continued to improve, you know, came in here, wasn't real sure his redshirt freshman year how far he would help us. Went through some tough times at home, but continued to battle, continued to fight. Again, I've said this before, I think he's one of the more improved guys. And then he sets into some adversity. He's not very he didn't produce very much. He got benched, you know, mid-season, and then he, you know, took advantage of his opportunity there at Vanderbilt when Ahmad went down and did a nice job. So, I mean, he's a guy that continued to work, you know.
Any final questions, Coach?
All righty. Thank you all.